friends. This is Pastor Randy, lead pastor of New Spirit Church. And listen, we're excited here at New Spirit Church about what the Lord has done and is getting ready to do. As a matter of fact, we want you to save the date. That's right, save the date, y'all. June 10th, 2017, at the 11 o'clock a.m. hour, we're going to be in worship right at New Spirit Church, celebrating 5 years of embracing the Spirit. That's right, 5 years. Where has the time gone? Listen, and leading up to that church anniversary celebration, every Thursday, we put out what's known as our Throwback Thursday Inspiration. Well, for the next several weeks, we got a treat for you. We're taking a trip back down memory lane. And so every Thursday for our Throwback Thursday experience, inspiration, we're going to post a moment of worship, a moment from one of our worship services over the last 5 years, and it's going to be absolutely awesome. Listen, we want you to embrace the Spirit and embrace the new you as you go back down memory lane. Look at somebody else and say, neighbor, oh neighbor, I thought you realized that I am a survivor. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Now, the book of Acts, also known as the Acts of the Apostles, I personally believe should be more appropriately called the Acts of the Holy Spirit. I say this because just about everything in the book is centered around God's chosen and how God empowered them to do what they do through the Holy Spirit. God bless each and every one of you streaming live in Atlanta, Detroit, Florida, and New York. We are familiar with the Acts of the Apostles because it is in this particular book where denominations began to disagree. Mm-hmm. Split and fall out. Mm-hmm. We're all right with Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, but when we get into Acts, we always have a difference of opinions, amen, pastors? But particularly with chapter 2. First of all, because of the misinterpretation or disagreement on who the Holy Spirit is and what Holy Spirit brings to us. Secondly, a major disagreement is on the issue of tongues and whether to speak or not to speak. Then there is the disagreement on whether signs, miracles, and wonders were for that time only. Then there is the disagreement that Acts 2:38 cancels out Matthew 28 and 19. Come on, Bible scholars, talking about baptism. But I really think we who have been survivors of horrors and seen and unseen ought to be able to stop this foolishness and this foolish talk and bickering and arguing about denominationalism, especially about water baptism. And I call them foolish discussions because none of them have anything to do with salvation. Can I preach it here tonight? Even though I am a progressive Pentecostal, I have sense enough to make sure that the main thing remains the main thing, that Jesus is Lord. I have sense enough to know that there are going to be some folks who have survived some dark, dilapidated, deceitful doctrines and dogmas, and the main thing has to be the main thing. Tell somebody the main thing has to be the main thing. Yeah, miracles, which I believe in, tongues, which I speak in, the gifts, which I flow in, nor baptism, which I indulge in, have anything to do with conversion. Because there's some folks that's talking in tongues and they're not saved. Okay, I'm going to walk a little heavy in here tonight. There's some folks that have been baptized and they still ain't saved. I know what I'm talking about. Baptism is a sign. It's an ordinance. It's something that we do because we are saved. It's not something we do to get saved. And I know this isn't a denominational church. I'm just building my case. Stay with me a little while. Yeah, so I'm over all this denominational junk. You know, a little one over here, and then another one pops over there, and then they split and start two more denominations. And folks always ask me, well, what are you? I say, I'm saved. I'm saved. As a matter of fact, why don't you lean over to somebody and say, I'm saved. I'm just saved. Yeah, I'm a little bit of this and a little bit of that. I get tickled when folk ask me, what kind of church is New Spirit Church? I say, we're Baptist because we believe in baptism.
We're Catholic because we believe in the universal church. We're Presbyterian because we believe in the laying on of hands. We're Pentecostal because we do speak in tongues. We're apostolic because we do believe in the works of the apostles. We're holiness because without holiness, no man shall see the Lord. We're Methodist because we believe in the method of Jesus Christ. We're Church of God in Christ because you can't have a church unless it's of God and in Christ. Somebody shout, I'm saved. And I'm a survivor. Then we walk through the book of Acts in chapter 3. A lame man survives because Peter and John gave him a touch of healing. They said, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, I give unto thee. In chapter 4, Peter and John survive a humiliating prison experience. In chapter 9, Paul survives because he yields to the instructions of the Lord. When he's knocked off his ass and he's told to get up and go up to a street called, that's a real word, by the way, y'all, it's in the Bible, I didn't make it up. He's told to go down the straight street. In chapter 10, Cornelius survives because of a heavenly vision. In chapter 13, a blind man survives even on the isle called Cyprus. In chapter 20, a man survives who had fallen out of a balcony because Paul had had a shut-in. And he was preaching all night long, and the man fell out of the balcony. And the Bible teaches us and tells us that Paul stopped preaching and went down and laid hands on the man and said, live again. Somebody shout, I'm a survivor. And then in the end of the book, Paul survives after standing before Felix and Festus and Agrippa and Caesar and even a shipwreck. Want you to know today, you're looking at a survivor. And I'm just crazy enough to believe that there are some survivors in here at the Outlet Church. Oh, yeah, all you have to do is look at the leader. The leader is a survivor. Think about you, Apostle, and just the few things that you shared with me, testimonies. I know a few things, and I've seen you go through. I just know that I know that I know without a shadow of doubt that you are a survivor. Somebody shout it again, survivor! Some of you sitting in here looking at me like I got three eyes in my head. Somebody tried to kill you off too. As a matter of fact, they come around every now and then just to see if you're dead, just to see if you're still alive, just to see if you're still kicking. And then when they see you up in here shouting up against the wall, they've been looking like, I thought I tried to knock them off their devil. I tried to knock them off their square. But somebody in here shout out to survivor. There were folks that said you would never be nothing, that you would never do anything. But we have to realize is that we as believers have the ability to make it through some stuff that the unbeliever can never make it through. As a matter of fact, the unbeliever can't even imagine dealing with some of the hell that we deal with. I feel a little preachy if y'all would push me in here. We have the power to bounce back from stuff folks said we would never bounce back from. Before there was ever a television show called Survivor and they were giving out $1 million as a reward, we knew how to survive. Oh, come on, people of God, we knew how to survive. We survived major catastrophes. Let's just consider 9/11. Those planes didn't have to crash in New York. They could have crashed in Atlanta, Detroit, or even Valdosta. But God had another plan for you. We survived with little of nothing because of the wisdom of our parents. Are there any survivors in here tonight? I said, are there any survivors in here tonight? Before we were able to go to Longhorns and Ruth Chris, and eat steak and lobster, we have to survive. We learn how to survive on hot dogs and pork and beans. Okay, now y'all want to have people here tonight. We learn how to go in there and make a fried bologna sandwich. Don't look at me in that tone of voice. You know you were fried till it bubbled up in the skillet and put it on a piece of white bread and put just some mayonnaise on it. Yeah, miracle, we'll be good for that. You put some mayonnaise on it. And you know what? We couldn't go in there and get a cold Pepsi. Oh, that's right, I'm in the South. A cold Coca-Cola. We had to go in there and get us some red Kool-Aid. Now y'all see me acting like that. You ate, and you ate good, and you survived. High five somebody and say, I'm a survivor. He survived. We didn't have color TV. We had a little black and white TV machine that was missing the antenna. They didn't have no antenna, and the knob was gone. That's when they had CBS, NBC, and ABC. That was it. TV would go off at a certain time of night. And you, if you wanted to get up, if you had to change the channel, you were the remote. You did not have a remote control. You were the remote. You had to get them pliers. And Lord forbid if they lost the pliers somewhere. You got to try to turn that knob. Somebody shout, I'm a survivor. Believe tonight the voice and the posture of the believer should be like Destiny Child's song. There were folks who thought, Pastor Brown, you wouldn't survive without them. But look at you out there, church. Just look at your leader. You survived. Some of you, even in your own lives, had someone around you who thought you wasn't going to make it without them. Oh, it got real quiet in here. You have somebody in your life that thought, oh, after I leave, they gonna die, it's gonna be over. But let me help you bust their bubble. And I had to keep reminding myself of this the last month or so. Ain't nobody in this world worth you losing your sleep over. Ain't nobody in this world worth you losing your destiny over. I had to remind myself, and Pastor Pierre, and Pastor Vincent, and Pastor Deshaun had to shake me and keep shaking me verbally and say, get yourself together. To remind me, ain't nobody in this world worth you losing your joy over. I don't care how wrapped up you are, you know. I'm preaching to myself in here. I don't care how good they throw it back. I don't care how they look. It's not worth it. Somebody say it's not worth it. Anybody worth you losing your sleep over? I had to keep reminding myself of that. You can live. You can make it and survive with or without them. So the song, I'm a Survivor, is important to me because the song shows us, the saints, really what we should be thinking. Tell somebody, stop your stinking thinking. This song shows us what we should be thinking. Now, it goes on to say, now that you're out of my life, I'm so much better. You thought that I'd be weak without you, but I'm stronger. You thought I'd be broke without you, but I'm richer. You thought that I'd be sad without you, but I laugh harder. You thought I wouldn't go grow without you, but I'm wiser. You thought that I'd be helpless without you, but I'm smarter. You thought I'd be stressed without you, but I'm chilling. Tell somebody I'm chilling. I wouldn't sell without you. I sold 9 million. I'm a survivor. I'm not going to give up. I'm not going to stop. I'm going to work harder. I'm a survivor. I'm going to make it. I will survive. I'm going to keep on surviving. You thought I couldn't breathe without you. I'm inhaling and I'm breathing. You thought I couldn't see without you, but I've got perfect vision. You thought I couldn't last without you, but I'm lasting. You thought that I would be dead. I would die without you, but I'm living. You thought I would fail without you, but I'm on top. You thought that I would be over by now, but I won't stop. You thought I would self-destruct, but I'm still here. Even in my years to come, I'm still going to be here. Somebody shout, I'm a survivor. And then for how things turned out, I didn't hear nobody ridiculed for no reason at all. But guess what? You survived. We survived the lies. I learned this a long time ago, that when folks don't know anything about you, they'll make stuff up about you. Yeah. Oh, yes, they will. Have to remember, though, that a lie will die and the truth will always stand. We survive the lies and the ridicule. We survive the hurt, church hurt. Folks scandalizing the name, but you survive. You survive the great losses, Pastor Brown, losses of people and things. But you survive the pains, the deaths. You survive the tricks of the enemy. You survive, people of God. Some of you survive the breakup, the relationship breakup. Broke your heart into a million pieces. They told you they wouldn't hurt you like the other one did. They told you they would never cheat on you. And they did just that. And they dumped you like a bad habit. But look at you. You survived. Say it again. I survived. Yeah, you survived that. You survived them walking around like all was well and la-di-da-di, everybody. And you had all this on you. Some of you had to get up here and preach. Some of you had to get up here and sing, praise team, with your heart broken to a billion pieces. But you survived. You survived. You have no idea. You have no idea what some people had to go through. Had to cry a whole lot, but they survived. Had to talk to their brothers and sisters, but they survived. They survived the attacks. They survived the strongholds. Some folks survived addictions and survived poverty and broke days. You survived being misunderstood. You survived misunderstood ambition and false accusations. I can hear you. We survived loneliness and rejection. Lord have mercy. We survived heartaches and heartbreaks. We survived hypocrites and two-faced people. You survived rape and molestation. You survived dead doctrines and dogmas. Pastors, we survived folks we thought was going to be with us, but then they left. Somebody say, I survived. We survived the loss of jobs and the loss of money. We survived the persecution of the so-called righteous. And guess what? You can actually take a praise break right here, Elder Tyrone, because you're not in a coma. Hallelujah. You're not in a mental institution. You're not dead, as a matter of fact. You're using those attacks as stepping stones. You're using all that stuff and those attacks as stepping stones towards your destiny. Somebody shout it again, I'm a survivor. So as a matter of fact, don't worry, because the ship might go down, but you won't lose your life. Would you look at somebody next to you and say, neighbor, oh neighbor, the ship might sink, but you're going to live. You're going to live. I know what your credit looks like, but I came to declare tonight that you're still a survivor. I know that it looks dark right now, but you're still a survivor. I know what's going on in your family, but you're still a survivor. I know you're in a hectic relationship, but you're still a survivor. I know you've been in depression, but you're still a survivor. No matter what the enemy says, I still believe God. Somebody shout, I'm a survivor. Somebody shout, I'm a survivor. Come on, clap your hands and shout, I'm a survivor. And so the text goes on to say that they were shipwrecked, but God showed them a view of their deliverance. He showed them the way out. He showed them the way through. He showed them the shoreline. And so the ship was shipwrecked, broken into a million pieces. Have you ever been in something and it seemed like it was safe and secure? And then all of a sudden, it breaks into a million pieces. You can't even seem to get yourself together. You had to move in a hurry. You had to get out of there in a hurry. You had to grab what you could. Oh, come on, don't look at me in that tone of voice. You had to grab what you could and maybe jump out the window and get out of there in a hurry. It seemed like it was perfect, but then it broke into a billion pieces. And in this text, the ship broke into a billion pieces. And so Paul tells them that you're going to have those that you can swim. Go ahead and swim the shore. But he said, if you can't swim, grab a hold to one of these boards. And if you can't get a hold of a board, grab to one of the broken pieces. I don't know about you, but sometimes in life, I had to grab to a broken piece. I had to grab to a board. I had to grab to what I could find. And some were swimming, and some floated on boards, and some floated on broken pieces. Good evening, Outlet Church. May the Lord bless you real good. I came tonight to tell you that you can survive with leftovers. You can survive with a broken heart. You can survive a broken family. You can survive a broken relationship. A broken foundation. Tell somebody you can survive. Come on, put those hands together. All of us survive. And give God the glory because you survive. something that sometimes we forget about, that the word of the Lord is the reason that we survive. Sometimes we call and look around to the wrong people, and we call our prayer partner, they don't have nothing to say. But I came to remind you that you gotta look to the hills. From which cometh your help, all of your help comes from the Lord. And so you might have to say, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Who shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Who shall I be afraid? My daughter might be hollering and my chains may be strained, but I'm a survivor. My family might be checked up, but I'm a survivor. My whole life might be messed up, but I'm a survivor. Somebody shout, I'm a survivor. Come on, put those hands together. Don't panic, baby. I need you to bless the Lord. Let me know that you know you are a survivor. I'm here to bless the Lord. Come on, stand up your feet all over this place. I'm done. I'm glad I took it up to the Lord. Hallelujah. Somebody shout it again. I'm a survivor. Out in that church, you are a survivor. And you're going to continue to survive. I speak in this atmosphere. The devil is a liar. You will survive. You will grow. You will be all that God wants you to be. Somebody shout, I'm a survivor. Come on, give him a praise. Chocolate.